Ahoy, matey.
Arr, matey.
Adventure on the High Seas awaits as your kids dive into the three pirate novels that are featured on this week's Summer Passport reading list.
Yes, Alamosa Books has been fostering the love of reading all summer long, though it's through its Summer Passport reading program. And even though kids go back to school next month, there is still a lot of time this summer left and plenty of books to read. Yeah. I just scared a bunch of children.
Well, we're happy to say that Jennifer Kenyak is back with us with the details. Hi, Jennifer.
Hello.
See why it's so important to read. You never know when you'll need it in life. No, seriously, though, Jennifer, it's so important what you're doing, and I want to remind our viewers who don't know a little bit about the Summer Passport reading program and all that it entails.
It's at the bookstore where I work, Alamosa Books, and it's a summer program for kids from first grade through 12th grade. Mm-hmm. We have three different levels. Those grades are divided. Mm-hmm. If there's a passport, we stamp it when they read their book and answer a little question. Each group has 12 books, and if they read 8 of them, they win a $10 gift certificate to the store.
Nice. That is nice. Well, and as Aaliyah said, you know, we're getting closer to back to school. Can kids still get involved?
Yes, there's still over a month left, so especially if they're avid readers, they're going to be able to read 8 in that period, but it's never too late to read some of them anyway.
No doubt.
We've covered 12 books on the reading list, and today we have three more. And all about pirates. Books for the youngest group, it's Scarlet Silver, Swashbuckle, by Sarah McConnell and Lucy
Courtney.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well, tell us a little bit about this book. This is for the younger kids, right?
Yes, and they're all three about pirates, but they're also all three about kids who are fighting to survive and kids who are being really brave. And that one is about a little girl whose grandmother was a famous pirate named Long Joan Silver.
Oh.
And
cute.
Her family was never interested in being a pirate until they discovered treasure, and then they decide to be pirates. But Scarlet, the little girl, realizes that they need to learn to be pirates, so they go to pirate school, and they get in some dangerous adventures.
Well, I know you were telling me before, but let's tell our viewers, why do the kids like the pirate stuff so much?
Well, I think, for one thing, the popular image of pirates that kids see isn't necessarily the most realistic but they represent independence and rebellion, and kids are really into that, and they talk funny, as you guys know. I was hoping you'd talk like that the whole show.
I can't do it. The one accent I can't do.
And they dress funny.
That's all I can say.
Oh, maybe.
Hire me, hearty.
See, she does it. We just need some patches to make this all work out. Well, and I also want to mention, we just obviously saw for the youngest kids, but there's something for the middle schoolers as well.
Yes.
We want to tell them that is actually called The Voyage of the Sea Wolf, and that is written by Eve Bunting. And what's this book about?
That one, what's neat about that book is it starts right in the middle of the action, and it's about two teenagers, a girl and a boy, who are marooned on an island when it starts, and they're rescued by a pirate ship that has a woman captain. But this woman is very sort of mysterious.
Whoa.
And she takes a strange interest in the boy of the pair.
Interesting.
And
okay.
It gets sort of dangerous.
It gets dangerous.
It gets dangerous.
So this is good for this age group. And then, of course, for the older sets, The Wreckers, written by Ian Lawrence. And so that's what age group is that considered?
That is for the 9th through 12th grade.
9th through 12th.
The older kids.
Yes.
So tell us about The Wreckers.
It's about a boy who's always wanted to be a sailor, and he finally gets to go on his first trip on the sea, and they wreck on this another mysterious island, but this one isn't on any map, and it turns out that the people on that island lure ships to wreck there so that they can loot them. And instead of rescuing the people, they kill them. So the boy has to try to survive.
Pirates.
Yes.
There's a little manipulation going on. Well, and I think this is what's so cool, is that there really is something for everybody, because certain age groups, certain books just aren't appropriate for them.
Right.
And you pick, and you do that. You do all the research for us. So it's great for them. And so I know as we get into the fall, Alamosa Books has some special things planned. What can you tell us?
Yes, we do. The book publishing industry is really seasonal, and fall is a huge season for books. Lots of new books come out in the fall, and we have lots of events coming up. The next one we have is August 23rd, and it's the author of a series called The Princess Academy, and we're having an event at the theater at Albuquerque Academy, and also a meet and greet with her. And on September 21st, we're having a birthday party for The Hobbit. The book is 75 years old.
Nice.
And viewers can get more information about that on our website.
Fabulous.
I love The Hobbit.
Well, you know, and there's so many bookstores out there, but what sets Alamosa Books apart from all those chain bookstores that we see everywhere else?
The main thing is we all are very passionate about books, and we know our customers, we care about our customers, we'll give great recommendations, and we're really part of the community.
Yeah, and you get to know the readers.
Yes.
I like that. Are you going to go in and get on the passport program?
Yeah, I kind of want to.
We do have adults who read along, too. You won't win the prize. But
and do you read each of the books?
Yes. Well, yeah. I read at least part of each of the books. Yes.
To get a sense.
Yes. Yeah.
Let me ask you one more question. When we talked like last week about Hemingway's book or some of the other books on the list, once we pass that and we get into a new theme for the week, does that mean it's too late for them to go back and read something else that was on the program and still get stamped? Can they still do
that? No, they can. All of these books they can read all summer long.
Okay.
Throughout this, the whole summer, which is, we still have one more month of summer, kids.
Right.
One more month still. No rush.
Not 1 week. 1 month.
So quickly, tell us where our viewers can go for more details about the summer reading passport.
They can come into the store, which is on Paseo del Norte and Barstow.
Okay.
Or they can go to our website, alamosabooks.com.
Perfect. Wow, Jennifer, thank you so much. I always get great information. It makes me want to go back to school.
Back to school. You want to go back to school shopping?
I want to go back to school shopping, too. And still ahead on New Mexico Style, we are exploring the Trail of the Ancients. Don't go away.